Welcome back. In this video, we are going to learn about static member functions. So we are going to see what is a static data member and member functions. So this is something like, there'll be situations where a function should be accessed directly without using an object. So we have seen every data member, every member of the class should be accessed to the object, but there'll be cases where we need to access it directly without creating an object. So static data member and member function can be accessed directly without making use of an object. So let us see how we can do it. Normally we use a member function called static member function. This can be written in the prototype. This should be prefixed. Don't get confused with the static member and constant member. Static member are the members which can be accessed without creating an object. Okay, so you have to prefix the function prototype with the keyword static. If it is a member data, the member data should prefix with the keyword static. So let us see an example. So where you can find a class called account, and we have we have a static data member which is a interest rate. At the same time, we have a static member function which is set interest rate. So this is what my class called account. Now what I do is, without creating an object of the class account, I need to access, I can access the two members which are static. One is my static data member, other one is my static member function, right? So how this is done? Look at this. We have accessed this directly, so we have not created any object. Look at this. Without creating any objects, we have done it. And even we have accessed this directly, interest rate is equal to P. We are accessing it. So without taking help of an object, we can access the data member and member function if it is defined as static. Next is objects and functions. So I hope you remember, objects are nothing but variables. It's a class variable. So which are the places where we can use the variable? In all the places we can use even an object. They can be appear as local variable. They can be passed as value or by value, or even they can be passed by reference. Let me repeat, objects are nothing but class variables. So which are the places we normally use a variable? In all the places we can use the objects. Why? Because basically objects are variables. They can be used as local variable, they can be used as pass by value, or they can pass even by reference to the functions. So let us see a small example. So here we have a class, we have the main program. We are not writing the actual class, we have the main program. Inside the main program, so D1, D2 and D3 are something like a local variables. Even though they are objects, they looks or they appears like a local variable. Objects can appear as local variable. This is something like I write int a. So What is a? A is a variable, local variable for the function called main. Then using this, I can access this we have learned before. And look at the next statement. So here, what we do is we are going to pass this object as pass by value. Even you can pass this object as reference. Look at the definition for this. So we have the function for add function. We have taken an add function. So how this is defined? So let me conclude. An object can appear as local variable instead of function, or which can appear as or they can be represented as pass by value or by reference.